We're all glued to our electronic devices these days, but few of even these Stanford students may know that electronics are called that because of the electrons within them, which makes digitally connecting with friends possible. And inside this building on the Stanford campus, deep in the basement, physicists are working on a project that is proving theories about the ways in which electrons act.
And once you move these, you often have to kind of fine-tune them.
They've built something they're calling designer electrons by moving one molecule of carbon monoxide at a time and placing each one into a honeycomb pattern. The pattern can then be manipulated and stretched.
3,000 of these images, if we line them up, that would be about the width of a human hair, so it's quite small.
Practically speaking, the outcome of the project could someday result in electronics that are faster, lighter, and burn less hot.
Another reason is size. So graphene is naturally a very tiny material because it's only one atom thick. So this is also why people are interested in it. You don't have to shave down a big material and make it very small. Your starting material is already a single atom thick.
It's the first time designer electrons have been made that appear to have mass added and taken away, travel at the speed of light, and even have positive and negative charges changed. The shape is modeled on graphene, which is a pure form of carbon that scientists think may be ideal for electronics and may replace silicon in electronics one day.
We're looking for a lost atom.
Ironically, the artificial manufactured graphene is too small to actually test for faster electron speeds. At one atom thick, it would have to be much thicker to hook up to wires. Still, the lab says it has proved something remarkable, that graphene may well be the next great electronic device substance.
In any case, it's the first time that anyone has seen this phenomena because it's hard to replicate or impossible to replicate with real graphene.
At Stanford, Carrie Davis, IDG News Service.